And so it should work now. I hope it works. Katya, call me if it doesn't work. From the experiences of Dimple, it I feels that, you know, I'm now convinced that you are getting great answers, that whatever you're doing is good. So far, he was just complimenting Dimple. When we get a loss in life, at that time we don't have the jagruti, the awareness at the right, at a time, at that time. Later on, I have to do pratikraman and come back into awareness. How can you have the instant jagruti that you are having right now? I want to know more about it. After it has happened, 5 minutes or 10 minutes later, if it happens, it is called at a time only. Depending on the intensity of the karma force, you see, when it is very high karma force, heavy karma, you might not have the awareness at that time, but then it comes back again. So different people have different intensity of the force of their karma that is unfolding, and that is why there will be different reactions. If it's only 10 to 15 degree force, then it will be there. Everybody, all of us are in the same boat. As soon as the critical thing is the awareness, and the awareness is there of the Raina Sile, and then there is along with that the Pratikramana Pratyakhyana is already there. We have the example of Lord Mahavir, in whose ears they were sticking nails, and he was aware that this happened. No, don't we have to have that in such instant awareness? No. You see, you just have to see. You don't have to blame the doer at all, because this is his evidences in life. That is why he's doing it. So you don't blame the evidences. You see, whatever is have, we have those evidences. You know, we have the gnan behind those evidences, the double A, double B, and we do not want to create new account with anyone. We just want to settle the account that is there in front of us, whether it is pleasant, complimentary, or painful and hurtful. Next one. In the example of the goldsmith, and in this way, you are doing the testing of the gnan only. You are actually only giving gnan at all times, just like a goldsmith. I wanted to ask about Dadashri's partner. His partner said that you do focus on the religion and I'll take care of it. And he says that, But his partner said that, give me a little bit out of it, you know. What does it mean? What did he ask for? He says, if you are in satsang, then give me a little bit of these energies of satsang, because you're free to do satsang, I will manage the business, that's all. Next is Yogita. And then Nirali Patel in ATPL. Jesus. Lakshmi, money is a byproduct, says Dada. You don't have to do anything for money. It will. And then later on. And also he says that you are not to let go of your current business or whatever you do, so that you have to do your work. Isn't this contradictory? On the one side he says you have to work, and the other side he says money is a byproduct. The important thing is that you should not have money as the main production. If you do hard work so that you go run after money, you will not get much benefits. You see, you know, you get money on the basis of what you have done good in the previous work. All the positive things that you have done, the helpful things to others that you have done is the reason why you are getting money in this life. And if in the current life also you do the same, then you will get automatically by production money as a by production naturally in the next life. Making your business or your work or situations are to be done naturally. Vyavasthit is the doer. You have to, Vyavasthit will inspire you one way or the other. Yeah. You see, if the Vyavasthit will inspire you to fill applications here and there, and you will get the appropriate job. But to really worry about when will I get it, which will I get, and what will I have to do in order to get it, etc., those are wrong things. You see, if the subatomic particles are demanding certain kinds of vegetable, it comes outside. But you see, don't you have to go to get the vegetables? Yeah, but you know, I have a question on chit. They said that chit goes out of the body. But how come I'm not able to see what is happening in the kitchen here? You can't believe your own wife in terms of what she says, then how are you going to believe what's happening in Unodri over here in terms of what lunch is being prepared for you? Yes, when your veils are all removed, when you have Kevad Gnan, then you'll be able to see everything everywhere all over the universe, you see. But right now you are only colored by the veils of what your wife tells you and you're upset with it. How are you going to know what's happening in the kitchen over there? Next one. Yogesh Damodar, Junagadh. Shobha Rani, Bangalore. Mayur Agrawat, ATPL. Jai Sachidanand Deepak Bhai. For the last 3 years, I am reading books of Dada. And I have done deep studies of karmic path, but I was not able to get rid of my kashais. But through Dada Vani, I feel my kashais. I just have taken Gnan 10 days ago. Yogesh Savariya, Junagadh. And I have done a lot of kashais before my Gnan Vidhi. Will I become free from it in this life? Yes, pratikraman is the answer. If we done all of these 8 days samayik, that is, when you do samayik of the sticky files, where you have hurt them, how you have hurt them, why you have hurt them, and you know, then you if we ask for the forgiveness from their pure souls, then you've done. What is the best answer? The best answer is keep it separate, keep uva separate, and then through the five agnas. What if I have done mistakes about the Gnani? That is the only thing. Keep it separate. You didn't do it. All this bhavana of Jagat Kalyan, hey Dada Jag Kalyan Karo, is it necessary that we have to clear up by 100% before we do Jagat Kalyan? Yes. Yes, when you become... Yes, you can do the Jagat Kalyan through bhav or intentions. You don't have to go about doing it. That comes much later. At least you come to satsang. You know, if you join the service organizations of Dada Shri, and you know, give your, and that is also part of the work of Jagat Kalyan only. No, but I have kashais right now. No. Even as you are giving service, even as all the kashais that arise, they will all automatically become free from it. You will become free as you are serving. Yesterday was my birthday. Please bless me. Yes. Okay. That's good. Next one. by the Samayik on invited pain and begged pain. In that, I was able to see a lot because I wanted to impress others. I expected results. I had the pain of moha, illusory attachment. When I used to play cricket as a child, when I become out, if I take the wrong shot and become out, then I will suffer. Because I have always wanted to impress that I was a good cricketer and a good batsman. Why did I get out? So, I always kind of, I go behind and say, what would I do? My mind goes backwards and always is rethinking and redoing it. And even now it is happening. Now keep it separate and slowly and just say, this is all invited pain only. This is all your kalpana only, your imaginations only. It is not reality, And set the five agnas, AA, BB, and the evidences of flawlessness, and you'll move forward beautifully. What you had bound it through ignorance, and this is why, and you'll be able to become free from it through knowledge. Shuddha will be right back in 1 minute. And I'm back. Let's see what's going on. And when you are worried about other people, because you are suspicious, when you're suspicious about people, this is, oh, she's talking about me, he's talking about me. This is all begged pain. This is vahori lidelu duk. Vahori lidelu duk. You are inviting pain only. This is part of the Agnani Bhavo, isn't it? The middleman. I want to understand it. Grant me, bless me, bless it. Next one. Sashikant Visavadia and Puppet by Rathod. Jai Sachidan, Manan Modi, Palanpur. I am talking about selfish intent and selfless intent of love. Love without selfish intent. But you see, because of my position, lot of people have expectations about me. At that time, what should I do? That is why if you're a doctor, the patients will ask you for things. And you have to serve others, you see. Yes, he's a doctor, by the way. And so he says, if they tell you, yes. So as a doctor, I can help others. But I do have that intention. I want to help them, yes. As long as it's possible. If he has expectations, that's fine. But you should not have any selfish intent. But you see, when you have a patient, he says, oh, you are a life insurance agent. So will you do this for me? You see, you can satisfy their expectations, but you should not have any expectations or selfish intentions through your patients, you see. And you should not have rag or dvesh towards them. Just settle the files with equanimity. Why are all of these parasites after me? None of that kind of attitude, you see. I do serve other people. I know. And I take salaries from the government. I have had some promotions also, so I don't charge patients any money, you see. And they appreciated me as a good doctor, and I'm the big person. When I also go and help where there is a deficiency of a doctor. So you should just tell them that everything is not under my control. I have to go by what the group decides. Are you able to do it yourself, or do you have to do it by as part of a team or in a plan? I'm a director, and therefore I have to ask the permission from somebody else. as much as possible, say that you are dependent on others. If you give them the sense that you are absolutely under authority, then you'll have more people expecting things out of you. I try to help others as much as possible. Yes, that is good. And then let go afterwards. Jai Sachidanand, Mohit Soni, Ajmer. I already have my answer, but I have one more question. Supposing I have a firm opinion about somebody, how can I become free from their opinion? Five Agnas, double A, double B, and the evidences of flawlessness. He is a pure soul, this is his field stock, and he is doing, his prakriti is negative because of circumstances. He is not the doer. The more you see him as flawless, then it will go away. And if it doesn't go away, it is your intellect that is showing you the faults and the opinions. Then turn it around and speak the positive, and every time the intellect shows you the negative. Supposing he's stolen something and I have seen that he is continuing to steal, what are you going to do? Don't you think you are doing the same mistakes over and over again? So even why is it that you continue to do bad mistakes even when people tell you not to do it? Therefore, you should recognize that, you know, your own prakriti is not under your control. How can you expect the other person to have any control over his prakriti? Yeah, the most you can do is to do some pratikraman and also and try to, you know, try to give him some understanding. But that is all you can do. Otherwise, there's nothing that you can do. You should see, understand that this is a sticky fault of his, and it is a sticky fault that is coming out as a field stock. If he can accept his own mistake, and if he is regretting these mistakes, and he does not protect his mistake, and then he is repenting his mistake, then one day for sure he'll become free from mistake. And that is applicable to him and applicable to you and all of us. Four steps, you see. Without seeing the other people as flawless, there is absolutely no way out of it, you see. Yeah, there's absolutely no way out of it. Okay. Chandubhai Gohil in Bharuch, and then Mohit Soni from Ajmer or wherever. Kaushik Satapara, Sihor Bhavnagar. Hina Kothari from Muscat. Kanta Patel from Rasikpura. Jai Sachidanand Bhai. I am a principal in high school, but when somebody is doing, there are kashais with my colleagues in school, and then I saw in Samaik that I'm a principal in a high school, so therefore I have certain degree of authorities, and I did a lot of pratikraman in the Samaik because of the abuse of my authority as a principal. And should I go personally and ask for forgiveness from the people, the teacher under me? No, right now close the pratyaksh, close the direct pratikraman from them, by openly asking for forgiveness. But if there is, on certain occasions, you know, then if it's possible, then you can say, oh, my dear friend, you know, dear fellow, you know, I'm so sorry. That otherwise, at the most, you know, try to continue to do subtle pratikramas through intentions only. Because because when you are doing pratikraman for a while, then these positive vibrations will reach the other person, because world is such that, but the only persons that you can ask for direct open pratikraman is when, and so you can only ask for open forgiveness to those who themselves are such that they will ask for forgiveness every time you ask for forgiveness. If they tell you more negative things, then they are not worth doing open pratikraman with. You see, you will be able to tell whether it is you are ready to do direct pratikraman or not. Until then, you have to continue to do silent pratikramans only. If you think that he will go in the wrong direction, then you have to stop. Send the positive energies and this to the pure soul within that person. Next one, Namaskar Deepak Bhai. I have already written. How come I get the other thoughts while I'm reading the other material? And grant me the energy to spend the rest of my life without anything. Yes, come into the satsang, shibir, samayiks, and when other people are hurt, do pratikraman. That is the correct path. Next, Hina Kothari. Yes, that's it. I don't have any question, but I want to. It must be my amazing merit karma that Niruma came to Muscat in 2002 in Muscat. And from that moment onwards, my vision changed completely. And for 10 layers later, and by taking the 8 parayan that I have attended, I have gotten the new energies for this. I am deeply grateful for your satsangs, and I get the answers, but this parayan and this living, I can understand the importance of your life satsang, and amidst all the kashais, I get the exact awareness now because of this. You have, as if you have given a big push, and now you have. What every day this samayik that I get is excellent results, you see. I feel very light after every samayik, and I cannot express the meanings. This is beyond words. I am deeply grateful for that. I am also deeply grateful to everybody who has arranged this parayan. I am very grateful to File 2 who has allowed me to come here from Muscat. And I wish also that I will want to have this. Jai Sachidan says, just a compliment. Deepakbhai says, yes, very good. Next. Ranjan Prajapati, Ahmedabad. And Swami Pat. Jai Sachidan. When it comes to the topic of boss and servant, and I recently became upset with my maid until I did some samayik and pratikraman about it, and because I was very bossy with that maid, and then I was worried that maybe, you know, he'll come back again. But I am clearing it out, this thing. Why am I creating a new file? I don't, because I was having it my way. Was it a female? Yes. But you see, you have a right to tell him that this is wrong. That is not called bossism. Yes, but everything else is, if you are normal, if you don't have an inner negativity, if you do not have any prejudices, if you do not have underlying opinions, then he will not get negative things. No, it's nothing like this. But then you're fine. You're just pointing out his mistake. That is all. So you should not be overly concerned that you will, in the next life, this female subatomic particles of willfulness will continue. You see, the being willful and having it my way only. I have decided that I don't want to have it my way. No, no, no. Just make him understand. Yes. Yes. Our service is doing very well because we are all doing it with abhed bhav, with oneness. And Navid Bhai Gotani, Rajkot. Yes, Sachidana Deepak Bhai. Shambhu Bhai Goyal. Sometimes I have to demand certain amount of work from the people, and I have to get a certain amount of output from the workers that are under me. And I give false certificates to people so that they can get promotions. Do you think they will get promotions and better money? You should have this. You should have this. No. You should not say that if you do good work, you'll get good promotion. You should just say that, you know, if you do sincerely, then it is good for your life, and then wherever you go, you will have safe side, because your sincerity is the energy by which you will, good things will happen to you. And you should have, of course, have the feeling that you should not have the wrong people, opinions about these people, that they do not work do their work properly. They are all doing their best, are they not? Generally, they are trying to do their best. And encourage them in a positive manner only. When I give them the idea of promotion, then only they work well. Otherwise, they don't work. Only when I tempt them with promotion, they work well. But you see, but you are giving them false promises and the promotions don't come, then it will all come back negatively. Has anybody that you have promised promotion gotten the promotion? I cannot give them promotion until their output is not good. Yes, encourage them, but don't give them false premises, you see. Otherwise, they will accuse you that this guy has been promising promotion, but I've never had the promotion, see. So always use words that will not bind you. Yes, Sachidananda. Ranjan, I have doubts about my file too. I don't want these doubts about my file too. Is he here? No, he's not here. Now live with love only, he says, or live with love. Deepak, we would have invited him, how was he? But next one, Prakash Kamdar. Today Dada Bhagwan has met me. 25 years ago, I met Dada Sri. I met other spiritual masters also. Despite meeting Dada Sri 25 years ago, I continued with the karmic path. In these 25 years, I never had any desire to get my work done. But because of the, there was a lot of turmoil and torment. And there are reactions. Now my files do not allow me to come to Akram Vignal also. They want me to stay put. The files get upset because I come to Satsang and Shibirs of Dada. So what should I do? How can I have the right kind of approach so that I can come to Akram Vignan Satsang Shibirs? Now, you come for the Shibirs and the Parayans, the major ones. But otherwise, Satsang, you go to the local Satsang Hirachan. But the rest of the time, you know, behave in such a way that you do not hurt each other and fulfill the expectations of each other. Because when you were, up until now, you were heavy in karmic, and at that time you make them suffer. And so now the reactions are coming. So they are not happy that you are continuing it in Akram also. So you should make the adjustments so that they will not have any misadjustments and they will turn positive themselves. And at the subtle level, continue to send signals to the pure soul of these people that are involved. And slowly they will clear up and they all too will come to Akram Vignan. This happens in many homes in India. You see, they let you go, but then afterwards they'll say, when is the program? We would like to also come. And slowly the whole gang comes. So this is going to happen. This is so beautiful, this Akram Vignan. Everything that you have done in karmic path, this is an easy path to dissolve your kashais and intellect and ego. And all the pain that you have been giving each other is because of kashais. And now once the kashais are gone, they'll be very good. So everything will be fine. So you keep coming to satsang, everything will happen. Now, Jai Sachidananda. Yogita, next one, Jai Sachidananda. When I am making file one do work sincerely, but if the circumstances are such that it may break our sincerity, and then I don't want to break my sincerity, then reset your sincerity. Your intention is there to do work sincerely, so then you do not want to get into any insincerity or pole, you do not want to find faults with anybody, you do not want to feed the kashais inside, then it will happen. But sometimes the other person is behaving such a way that I feel like my sincerity is gone. No, why don't you ask Aptaputras what kind of problems there are there, and they will take care of it. Next one, Ashok Surti Ankleshwar. Yeah, yesterday with reference to the give and take of money, and money related kashais, I was able to see in office we have to keep a certain amount of staff, and we have certain conditions with them that if they have to notify us if they want to, that we still have to give each other 1 month's notice. If after they give the notice and if they work for 1 month, don't you have to pay them the money? After they give the notice, then if they leave, then we are in trouble, and therefore, if they leave, then they will not get paid. If we are firing you, then we'll give you 1 month advance salary. But sometimes some people are unhappy, but they leave suddenly, and then so we do not pay them for the 1 month, 15 or 20 days worth of salary. Do they come back to us for the money? But because of the conditions, we do not give, so we have not been able to give them their money. Is it good or not? Because it was a signed agreement. Is it correct or not? And what should I do? If it is not correct, then what? It is like this. Money will come and go. You are a shit. You have the money. He is a servant. You see, please your servant. You can just say you're not going to get the salary, but because you work for 4 months, 4 years, I'll give you the bonus. And so, okay, money, he's concerned with the money only. So you're not breaking the contract, but you're giving him a bonus, you see. You see, you don't know his circumstances. I found out that human beings are looking for love only, you know. They don't care about less money or more money. They look for love. If they find that you are very good, then they will treat you well, you see. So why does he leave you? Find out why is he leaving your business. Does he not find what he's looking for by working for you? Find out, is it just the money or is it much more? You know, for 20 years, my servant, people who were working under me did not leave their job. Because, you know, I always gave him them bonuses and I were never bickered, you see. Yeah. Well, if he comes to me, then I will always take care of him, you see. Now, let me tell you the other side. You can do whatever is right as far as the money is concerned, you see. But the second part is that, why is he leaving after not doing work for you? There must be something. Is there anything deficient in me that he has stopped working for me? You see, your business is running on the basis of their work. You are a boss because they are there, you see. If they go away, so inside you should be grateful to them for having worked for you. But inside you should be grateful to them. And you know, if you give them they may need some more extra money because they are after all working for you. So if you can be nice to them, then it'll be nice, would it not? So, you know, there'll be a slight decrease in your profit, but even decrease your profit and give them a little bit, then they will, there's human beings that they will be take such good care of you that you will become free for satsang. And you will be able to come to satsang and they will take care of you and they will be able to do your work sincerely. Therefore, take care of the human beings who are working for you. Now, another work. I'm not talking about you only. Now, I'm talking about everyone in general now. Now, this work is gone. Let me just protect human beings. The people who are here, you don't know who is that. You always protect the human being who comes to you. Do not be involved with the profits issues, you see. What did you come with when you entered this world? You see, so if you can protect one human being, if you can help one human being, his feelings for you, his intentions for you, etc. will be there, always there, and he will get such blessings for you. He will give you such positive blessings for you that it will cover. But if you have negative intentions and you are only money-minded, then what will happen is that, you see, they will spread negativity about you and your negative, they will create vengeance with you unnecessarily. So, look, see how Dada lived with his own partner. His partner says, you focus on satsangs and I will take care of everything, you see. So, I'm just telling you general. We need to develop these skills, you see. This for 20 to 30 years, if people are working for us, then he should feel love, he should get what is his due share. You should, even if you give him less salary, of course, take care of his other problems in life. you know, take care of the education of his child, etc. You see, or if he's sick, go and pay the fees for his hospitalization. Or in this way, you are kind of going, you know, he will say, boy, he's like a god, he's like a dev, he's like a celestial being for me. You see, how you treat your fellow human beings is a thermometer of how much of a god you are, you see. And then it will say, but otherwise you are just an ordinary human being, are you not? And so, yes, you see, then even he will call more people to work for you, you see. You don't have to go looking for people to work for you. So you should, it's very important to be very kind and caring and be very protective of the people who are working for you, you see. You know, and you know, instead of giving him the salary, call him on a Diwali and give him a bonus. That way you're not breaking the contract that is written for your company, but you see, you're giving him the money in some other way. I have people 25, 35 and already people who are working for a long time within me, but the new people who come, they expect, you know, the moment they get a slightly higher pay somewhere, they immediately leave, you see. And then you can ask him, why is it that you're leaving? He says, yeah, look, there are people who are working for 35 years. If you work a little bit hard, you all too will get very good salary, you see. So make him understand. He says, we will take care of your salary, but are you going to show me something that makes you deserve a higher salary and a promotion, you see. So try to communicate with the thing. Try to protect the mind of the person. I'm not talking to you specifically. This is a general way of approach. Devanshi Soni, next one. Anhakni Lakshmi, the money that is not rightfully mine. And so, so I had a lot of competitiveness because we were goldsmith and yes, you know, so he will. So we were deceptive in taking over his clients, and this way we did Anhakni Lakshmi. In this way, we took away the clients of the other person. You see, the competition. He was so good that he would say that, yeah, I've got no problem. You know, so they took away the business of a fellow competitor goldsmith. You see, by becoming nice to him and then finding out what his clients were and then approaching his clients directly. And I have done a lot of this kind of deception in life. Even when I was making khakras, I used to steal oil when I was doing catering for other people. You see, you know, because you had stolen in a previous life, the results of suffering came in this life. And when you were doing the wrong approaches, you were suffering again. But now, when you are repentant for the mistreating these other people, that is wrong. You know, whatever I did, let them get multiplied 100 times, let them get it. And you know, on the days that is possible, you know, get rid of that extra money that you received. Just take it, get rid of it. Because if the wrong money comes in your home, it's going to bite you all over. Yeah, should I have to do something positive? Always have the right kind of attitude for his business. Yes. Now we should not be in much suffering, you see. But you see, now do the pratikraman. Now you are not doing anything wrong, right? No, I don't want to do it. I don't want to do this kind of deceits now. And then go, if possible, go and say, listen, this is what I did. Is it okay to just go and say, oh, and someday you can go and openly discuss it. And then yesterday you said that. Yes, sometimes we have to, when you have a lot in your mind, then you know, write down, if there's a storm in the mind, take a piece of paper, you have to deflect yourself, and then write down in a piece of paper, Dada, there are all of these mistakes that are happening, Dada, I'm surrendering it to you, and then after surrendering it to the feet of Dada, then tear it off and throw it away, that's all. Otherwise, the best thing is to take each and every mistake, and then, you know, then you say, and to really connect with that person's pure soul, you know, find that says, you know, you have to see him as the pure soul, and then he is the, then we want to, But if you have 50 to 100 people coming out, negative false feelings are coming, then you cannot wash it. So the proper way to do it is with every negative fault, every negative intentions, every negative bhav, every abhav, you see, you have to do pratikraman for it, you see. And then pratikraman, wash it off. Now that if you do not have the energy to wash it, then of course, then you know, just write it down in a piece of paper and say, Dada, here it is. I'm surrendering it all to you. Please take care of it, you see. And then tear off the piece of paper, you see. And you see, but if you have a lot of negative opinions about the other person, then each of those opinions will have to have the have to be applied through the five agnas, double B, double B, the flawlessness of the other person, etc. So, but if you cannot apply the five agnas, double A, double B, or the evidences of flawlessness, then you got no recourse except to do the turn by turn pratikramans only. Next one, Mohit Saini. I want to know Mo, Asakti, and Rag. Mo is the initial thing. Mo means I'm deluded, and you become over. And then asakti is an internal, you know, because of rag, dvesh, subatomic particles, you are attracted to, there is attraction, and because, and then it will, there will be attraction repulsion cycle, you see, and then more asakti, and that's it. Ashok Surti and Dhirubhai Sindhav, speak up please. In a Gnan state, I had done a lot of kashayas before Gnanvidhi, I had done a lot of kashayas. And I used to counter-attack also. But after Dada's Gnan, I am aware that this is wrong. And then awareness is increasing. And now pratikramas are happening. And the effect of the pratikraman is also reaching. But what is the science behind the pratikraman of Dada? It is, the world is like a football, soccer, you see. You kick a ball, the other person will kick a ball, you see. But whenever there is the intention to hurt anyone or somebody gets hurt, then at that time find out and do pratikraman. So if you clear your own side, then as a result of it, the echo of it will go to the other person that, no, this person has any negativity towards me. And so is it over with it? Yes, ours clear up completely. Yes, it happens. Next one. Dhirubhai Sindhav, my question is, these nine columns, the ninth column, I want to become the Nimit of Jagat Kalyana of the world. What should I? We have the mission of Dada, that is 100%, there is no question about it. But because of space, time and situations, I cannot become a Nimit in the work of Dada. But every day I do the bhavana of the ninth column. But because of circumstances, I cannot become a Nimit for the ninth column. So I am coming to you as a Gnani. I want to know, in order to become the Nimit of Jagat Kalyan, what should I do? Nothing to be done. Do what the world is making you do. You should have the intention only. And whatever work is given to you or visible to you, is supposing on the basis of sexuality, if you see those Nimits, yeah, you see the pure soul in it, see them with three visions and do pratikraman and ask for brahmacharya and move forward, you see. And oh Dada Bhagwan, let them also attain liberation. So with on the basis of money you get so many people, and then you know, see their pure souls, and then you know, there's so many relatives that you see, that you know, send them all to moksha by having the positive intentions and sending the signals to their pure soul. In, you know, for sex, you know, whenever you are in a marriage situation where everybody is well dressed up, etc., etc., you know, now send them all to moksha by remembering their pure souls and sending them all to moksha only, you see, may they attain this. And at the gross level, you are in Surendranagar, you know, there you can give service in the centers of Surendranagar. You can go there and say, yes, please, I am not able to serve. If you're not able to serve, then it's fine. But if you can you give 2 hours in a month? Yes, then do 2 hours in a month, you see. But this is the science of intention only, and you proceed further. you know, whoever you see in this world, say, send them off to moksha by sending the positive energies of the ninth column through you and to the pure soul. May they attend this Gnan, may they attend this Gnan. That is actually the Jagat Kalyan Bhavna only, nothing else. Next one. In worldly interactions up until now, I am an inspector at a petrol station. If you make some kind of cheating, and if you put your adjustments in here so that we can get more gas out of so all the other inspectors are actually cheating so that their customers get less petrol, and if I disagree, then there is a problem. So everybody is adjusting, so that you have to do whatever you have to do, because you are doing, you know, your work is that you are the entire gang of inspectors are corrupt. So you, because if you try to kind of be the straight person, then you will lose your job. So do pratikraman, that you don't have to do this kind of job. You see that you do not. That you know, when will human beings come out of all of this hoarding of money and greed and hurting others because of corruption, etc. You know, so you say that I do not want to be in any kind of, but I have to agree, and I say, okay, we will give less petrol even for, so the meters are kind of rigging of the meters, you see. So you, the customer thinks that he's getting buying 5 gallons. But he ends up getting only 4.5 gallons, and he pays the money for 5 gallons or 5 liters, whatever. Oh my Lord, I don't want all of this, the money that comes in the wrong way, I do not want to use it for my own life. I do not want to misuse the money. So do pratikraman and pratyakhyan. It is because you have done, you know, because in the last life you have done the bhavana that, you know, even if I have to bend the truth a little bit, I want to earn money. So in this life, you get this kind of a job, you see. So, but now the new awareness says that I do not want this kind of money, and therefore you will slowly become free from it. So but to work sincerely, and so the office work has to be done by the manual assistant. We are field workers. And if we, so I, when I go to the office, I have nobody above me, so then I don't have to do any work. So I have free time in the office only. So, you see, now when you're taking free time like this, then in the next life you'll complain that my boss is not doing any work and I have to do all the heavy work. So just, you know, whatever your free time is, you should spend for Jagat Kalyan. Only, and for helping the world. So just move forwards in a positive manner, you see. You have the right use of your time only, and whatever you have to do, you have to, and you know, try to do something for satsang, da seva and dada, if as possible. That is all. For the right use, I feel that I don't have any ability. Then you just take the help from the Aptaputris and the coordinators. You will find something. Let us do the Samayik now. Samayik. This is a special Samayik. We do it every year in the Parishan. But now we are going to do it again. This, the mistakes with your colleagues, you see. On the basis of money, we do wrong business, you see. And then we have the wrong kind of crowd around me. And then for pride, we have the wrong kind of the groups. Then sexuality, we have the wrong kind of crowd with us, you see. So, but for pride, you know, we get the same kind of people in a circle. But for spiritual colleagues, you know, spiritual colleagues gather together for religion and religious activities. You know, they're done with the world, they're all in Mahatmas. You know, the worldly, the relatives will go away. You know, the people in the home will go away in 2 or 3, 4 years. But the spiritual colleagues carry with each other life after life after life after life. And they are with the same spiritual master too. Therefore, in ignorance, because of ignorance, there is rag, dvesh, vishay, kashay, all of those then all of those mistakes are happening to your, and the biggest mistake is in competition. You see, you know, he is serving this, he's trying to get into the best side of his guru, therefore he is the favorite guy and I'm not the favorite guy. And those mistakes of competitiveness is very bad among spiritual colleagues, you see. And so, oh, he is getting more, he does less work and he's getting a lot of pride and respect and validation. And you know, he does not follow the laws of the organization and yet he's being respected, etc. So the ego always will find always something wrong. And if it happens according to the ego, he likes it positive. If it doesn't happen according to the ego, it does not happen, then he sees negativity. And then these kashais of life after life then create wear, V-E-Y-R, animosity, vengeance, and then they take, then they go negatively against each other, even though they are spiritual colleagues. Let us find out where, like, we are going to do pratikraman of our spiritual colleagues. And this is the thing. And you see, even Niruma also gave the same message that, you know, live with love. Promise, you see, no matter what the difficulties, you will never see any fault with your spiritual colleagues at all. But we should not react, you know, we should not find her or him at fault at all. We want to live in her or him with love only. You know, see, Not all are in giving hurt to each other. Only those who are in a particular field, in a field, the coordinators I've got, and then sevarthis, you know, those who want to serve and they coordinate. And then those are groups, you see, there are different groups, you see, somewhere or the other they are stuck up. You see, and again they get the same work because they have done it before. They are not doing it for money, there is no interaction of money there, but you see, in the world, of course, you know, it has got everybody is concerned about position, etc. But here there is no interaction of money at all, and there is neither, and if you get a lot of respect, and then he considered pride as a profit, and you see, and if he is, so he considers this a loss when he does not, he is not appreciated, you see. And then he, the person who is getting insulted, he should say, no, this is my profit. And even, you know, if he gets pride, then he should say, this is my loss. I'm here to serve my own moksha only. I do not want to eat man. I do not want to eat pride. I do not want to be validated. If you do not want anything, any pride, and you do not, then you will be easily able to be work in a group situation where you will be. But if the ego and the intellect are such that they continue to interfere and they find faults with their spiritual colleagues, and that is why Niruma says, Prem thi rejo, this is a very ultimate sentence, live with love. This is mother, this is the ultimate desire of Niruma, so we should fulfill it, you see. No matter what he is doing it, we should, you know, whatever, but even if he is hurting us in no way, no matter how he is doing it, you see, we should not be concerned about it. At that time, we should understand, if somebody is tormenting us, giving us a hard time, we should understand that it is my own account. And Niruma has said, live with love, no matter how it receives you, you should be the embodiment of love only and nothing else, you see. And if you make that nishchay, then that I want to win this file with love only, then you will be able to do it. And if it happens that in 2 or 5 years you can't do it, you see, he can only hurt me with reference to the amount of the account that I have with him. Therefore, I want to become free from him. I do not want to find faults with him. I want to become the embodiment of love, because Niruma has said that be the embodiment of love with my spiritual colleague, whether he's in Germany or in Brazil or whether he is here or anywhere, you see. And you see, he's just a nimit. You see, it is through his nimit that I know where I am deficient. You see, and you see, so then we do not want to find faults with him. So nobody's worldly interaction is going to cause any kind of pain to you. It is our own weakness, our kashais, our weaknesses. Our kashais are our weaknesses, and therefore we need to rise above our weakness in here. So let us now not blame any of the nimits. Let us finish those mistakes, you see. We need to be in a perfect awareness of this, that form with the spiritual colleagues, we should not have the slightest spoilage in the mind or in the speech or with anyone. So then the ego gets spoiled, and then the speech gets spoiled, and then the conduct gets spoiled, you see. You know, look at the kind of people who are there. They are constantly spoiling Dada's work, you see. No. He is right. Vyavasthita has placed him there to get rid of our disease. So we should not find any kind of negativity, slander, negative opinion, negative speech for anyone. You know, you see, you are hurting both the people. You're hurting others as well as you're hurting your own self. So you can never say negativity. You can never slander anyone. You can never backbite anyone. You can never criticize anyone with this respect. Everybody understand this now? Especially in Sevarthi, coordinators, you see those, and you know, all the various departments, you see, they are, you know, the ones, you see, they are, if we are one with them, you see, then you will be helping everybody who comes for this seva. Like I said, then if we have oneness amongst ourselves, then this work of Dada will proceed further in a very beautiful way. We do not want to see the mistake of anyone at all. We do not want to hurt anyone. If somebody hurts us, then we need to discredit. We just need to credit it. We need to credit, and we do not want to become painful. We do not want... No, just solve it with Gnana only. You do not want to accept it in any way. Let the world attain peace and bliss only. You see? In the same way, when we Mahatmas are in Abhedita, oneness, then the Dada's Bhavana of Jagat Kalyan will magnify and will come into fruition in a very beautiful way. And you see, Srimad Swami, Lord, is there to help us, and the entire entourage of all the celestial beings are also there to help us, and Dada and Niruma. Dada is with us, Niruma is with us, her blessings are there with us, so therefore we need to, but they want us to become clear. They says, if you become clear through you, Jagat Kalyan will happen. If you clear yourself, then a medium will be the medium for the work for Jagat Kalyan, you see. But you see, we are always good with those who are not interacting with us, but those who come in interaction with us, that is where the testing is. That is where we have to be good with them, you see. And you know, these are all sahadhyayis, spiritual colleagues. They have the same goal and they are studying for the same reason, and I want to win them with love. If we keep that as goal, in 2 to 5 years, it will happen. And we will be able to, in this very life, we will be able to win them. So this is, and without winning them, there is no entry in Mahavidyakshetra, and that is why we really need to do it. And so this, for our own salvation, we need to really win over all of these spiritual colleagues. We do not want to have any kind of negativity to any one of them. And we do not want to find any faults with any one of them. You see, let us do the Purushat. Let us do a magnificent Samayang and look out everything where any kind of problem arose with any spiritual colleague. You see, find out if you saw any mistakes of any spiritual colleague. This happens at all the centers. But you see, it happens between coordinators and centers. Find out if it happens. Yes. And though whether you are connected with Adalaji or whether you are independent in elsewhere in another country, but you know, wherever you are, you see, in all your local satsang coordinators as well as centers in Germany, etc., wherever you are, you see, this needs to be, you know, there is no need for any man or pride. There is no need for recognition or validation. You see, the only reason I separate from the other person is because of my own kashay of pride. I want to be considered important. I want to be validated. I want to be in the primary driver's seat position. That is why. So let us make the nishchay today that I want to become free for it. I want to proceed this further with Gnana only. I want to win them with love, and I do not want to break any oneness with them. The Prakriti, it may happen through Prakriti, but your intention must not be there to break the oneness that is there with them. Let us do, everybody agree? Yes. Let us make the nishchay that I want to win my spiritual colleague with love only. It could be a colleague, you might be intimately connected in some work with Dada. It is, and the divisiveness happens due to the different Prakritis, but in the different intellects. Our intellect, when it shows negativity, that's where we really need to be clear of it. There is no role for our intellect in finding negativities of our spiritual colleagues. And therefore, we want to be supportive to him in whatever work he is doing. We do not want to do use our intellect with reference to human beings there. We want to use, we want to use the intellect to find the solutions in the work only and move forward. And we want to thus improve. We do not want to find him at fault at all. And thus, through the blessings of Dada, we will definitely find the energies to rise above. And we will see him flawless, and you know, there will be oneness with this person. And this is mandatory. Sooner or later, we will have to have this. When you become Atmarup, there is Prem, there is love, there is Vitarakta, absolutely. And so, you are the Atma, but you have to become that. You see, you are the Rhinocele, you have to become that. You are the God, you have to become that. So, let us do a very beautiful Samayik today. And wherever such mistakes have arisen with our, in our interaction with our spiritual colleagues or in service to the organization, let us find out where this error is and let us clear off from that and wash it off beautifully. And if possibly, you go in front of your spiritual colleague and say, "My dear friend, you know, I was terrible with you. Oh, dear Francisca, oh dear Uwe, I was terrible with you. Please forgive me, you know, I did not mean to do." Do open pratikramans with them. So, alright, so let us do a very beautiful vidhi today, see. And Dada, grant me the energies to get, do this in exactness. Oh Dada Bhagwan, the Absolute Self within me. Hey Shri Simandar Swami Prabhu, the Lord God at Mahavidik Kshetra, the fully enlightened one, with the exact applied awareness of the Self, Shuddhup Yog, having come into the worldly interactions of satsang with whichever spiritual colleague there has been for them, because of misunderstanding and lack of understanding through kashayas also, if any mistakes have been seen in them, if any pain has been given to them, anything negative has happened, let me see all those mistakes. And let me understand that these are all my mistakes only. That with the nimit, let me have the perfect flawless vision with the nimit. Let me apply the upyog, the awareness of the pure soul, and become the embodiment of love. And let me win my spiritual colleagues with love. Grant me the energies to do such a samayik, my Lord. I surrender the mind, speech and body, all illusions associated with my name, bhav karma, charge karma, dravya karma, subtle discharge karma, yellow glasses, no karma, gross discharge karma. Hey Dada Bhagwan, oh Dada Bhagwan, the Absolute Self within me, you are manifest within me, oh my Lord, you are the Paramatma, God within me. And it is at your divine feet I am surrendering all this. I am surrendering them all in totality. Atma chu, shuddhatma 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 chu, atma chu, shuddhatma 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 chu, Jai Sachidana. Go deep into your beautiful samayik and make a deep nishchay. Just as you want to become free from sexuality and pride, this also is a mistake of kashayas only, and you want to become free from this kashaya mistake. I want to become one with my spiritual colleague only. Do a beautiful samayik, and with the grace of Dada, you will come out of it. Jai Sachidana. Jai Sachidana. Shudatma Bhagavan. Jai Sachidana.